Alright. Packing up.
Driving right now. Arkansas. Roads been going pretty good. Going through Mississippi was pretty non-eventful. Spent the night in Memphis. Had pretty good, food for breakfast. And I've been on the road.
They said 20 miles to the gallon couldn't be done at Wrangler. Well, I'm doing it. Entered Oklahoma. Missed the damn sign.
Oh. Damn, so you skipped Texas Oklahoma. On purpose then.
Oklahoma's been pretty flat. Whole drive-through thus far. So this is the first. Hopefully next I'm going to go take a look at a statue of Woody Guthrie. Currently next to the Woody Guthrie Free Folks Festival in Oklahoma. The Jeep is cleaner than it was. Not as many bugs. This park was dedicated. Let's go take a look at it.
This land is your land, and this land is my land, from the California to the New York Island, from the Redwood Forest to the Gulf Stream waters. This land was made for you and me. As I went a walk in that ribbon of highway, I saw above.
Over into Texas, Oklahoma, elevations right over 2,000 feet, like 2,100 feet, according to Snapchat. Elevation, you already can kind of see, is getting a lot more hilly. I mean, I'm in Amarillo, why not? I'm in Texas, right? So Whataburger's from, so gotta give it a shot. I'm now entering New Mexico, land of enchantment. The Jeep's doing good. Fuel economy's going down a little bit as I climb. It's definitely arid. Definitely very arid. But yeah, just left Texas. Shop on the way. Super cool. I took a lot of photos with my auto clip on my phone. It's a little bit of a detour on my way to Albuquerque. Totally worth it. Got about 30 minutes of my time. Just opened, so like it was pretty much all to myself. There it is, the museum. It's called the Meselands Dinosaur Museum.
Okay.
Albuquerque. Just left my hotel. Residence Inn was really nice, by the way. Enjoyed it. Driving to Durango.
And
to
1/2 Phillip. Mile exit right.
Now, ain't no one to come and save you and pull you out. Beneath your lips lie the trick of it, babe. For a couple licks.
So I'm driving. I'm on US 550 outside of Albuquerque, heading towards Colorado. And I just wanted to say this is like probably the best landscape I've seen on this trip thus far. I want to show you.
No matter where you're going, I can't take you there. I can't guess to get you home, playing catch up to the moon. Say we're getting pretty close, so we're somewhere darker. Be a little more like you. I can't take you there, I can't guess to get you home, playing catch up to the moon. See, we're getting pretty close, so we're somewhere darker, with a little more bite, doom. Ain't nobody gonna come and save you and pull you out. Nah, ain't nobody gonna come and save you.
So, we're still in Durango. Our actual hike doesn't start till tomorrow, but Philip wanted to go ahead and start hiking the Colorado Trail today. It's pretty cool.
See that thing, the Titans there?
And we're off. Maybe some videos later, but it's beautiful. All right, catching in later. Day one on the Colorado Trail, next to a creek. About to go discharge the GoPro a little bit more.
Even though
turn. About to go meet up for the camp. We just got to base camp, and one of the first things we have to do is find our own camp and set up. So I found a place, camped pretty good ways over there off the road. Found a pretty nice natural campsite. Lots of coverage, less wind, any kind of rain. But found this little new hook. A lot flatter. I'm gonna be putting my tent right here. Have an Eno, so be able to fit the Eno on a lot of these trees. But there you go. Took a little bit. Cleared this space out a little bit. It's a lot flatter right there. So I got the tent up, sleeping bag, and my air mattress blown up. Just gonna see what else I can set up right now. Maybe my Eno. Cool. Center of about 2,500 feet. So this is our first official stop.
Kiss me hard before you go. Summertime sadness. I just wanted you to know the baby, the best. I got my red dress on tonight. Dancing in the dark in the pale moonlight. Throw my hair up real big, beauty queen style. High heels off, I'm feeling alive. Oh my God, I feel it in the air. Telephone wires above are sizzling like a snare. Honey, I'm on fire, I feel it everywhere. Nothing scares me anymore.
Hermosa Creek, came down. It's the down day. Water looks nice. Having a little lunch. A little over halfway out of today's expedition. But yeah.
down the coast, going about 99. Got my bad baby by my heavenly side. I know if I go.
How are you doing?
Good, how are you?
Good. Catch anything?
I just started a few minutes ago, but yeah, I got a couple bites so far.
Awesome.
Yeah, just like right there was my first cast tonight. Two bites on the same rock.
A little trout or what?
Yeah, a little brook trout. Yeah, if you keep walking, there's some, when you see the bigger holes, there's where the bigger fish are, and there's a beautiful looking rainbow that's maybe like that big, maybe, I don't know, a tenth of a mile up, but it's like in this really hard spot to cast, and you can't really get in there.
And he knows, that's because he knows where to go.
Exactly.
He didn't get to that big without being a little smart.
Exactly.
Have a good one.
Of day two. So we, I believe, descended about 2,500 feet. Not much incline at all. It was basically downhill. And we made it, actually, in the front of the pack, waiting on the other people. Beautiful view, though, down here. Because we've been seeing a lot of on top looking down, so it's cool to see a down looking up, I guess. So. Alright. Ready for bed. Charging everything. Getting organized. End of night three.
Can't you see that it's just rain?
First stop, just an out and back, about 2 miles. Easy day to kind of prepare us for tomorrow. It's kind of the hardest day. I'll be able to stay at camp as long as us came out. So, take it easy and have a nice hike.
Waking up too early, maybe we could sleep. Make you banana pancakes, pretend like it's the weekend now. Could pretend it all the time. And can't you see that it's just raining? There ain't no need to go outside. But just maybe like a ukulele. Mama made a baby. Really don't mind the practice, cause you're my little lady. Lady, lady, love me, cause I love to lay you late.
The midsection of the out and back. On the, I guess, the easy day before our hard day. You can see the trees starting to change a lot. And there's really like mainly two trees. There's spruce, which what we've really been seeing like the whole trip until today. And we've seen them, but walking through them. And now we're walking through called aspens. And they're really pretty.
We don't need to, we got everything.
Animals use, scratch them and use them for healing effects and stuff for itches. But cool. Alright.
Do we really need to pay attention to the alarm? Wake up slow. Up slow, but baby, you hardly even notice when I try to show you this song is meant to keep you from doing what you're supposed to. Waking up too early, maybe we could sleep. Make you banana pancakes, pretend like it's the weekend now. And we could pretend it all the time.
Not whole, not wholly separate, but syncopated, single in our nature, and because of the times, not a word was said when the lights came on, or a glance given pause at the cost of our desired wrongs. It's second nature to love you, it's first to die, and we were killed upon waking, killed upon.
Show y'all what I'm looking at, it's pretty cool. This has been a 4 mile incline. Like 1700 feet of gain. So.
And if I cry in your arms, just some other shit, just some other shit.
So it's the last day, full day, and night. We're doing Blackhawk's Pass. And right now we're passing creek. It's called Straight Creek.
Saying you were all I ever needed, and hold me like we're dying from the liquor that we drank down in hotel rooms to feel warm and cold love.
This is on top of Blackhawk's Pass. Just came up from that.
Saving trails.
Mississippi. It's 46 degrees. So I guess I'm on the second leg of the trip. Now I am going to be headed back down to New Orleans. So, but honestly, it's a lot nicer out here. It really is. Just the scenery is just great. And the weather. I mean, it's cold right now, but I mean, it's getting colder. But I mean, there's like no humidity. Back in like cattle, farmland. But yeah, heading to Roswell. Hopefully check in the hotel and then hopefully go look at the UFO center. Down here, I guess we're getting closer to the Texas border. And let's see.
checked in a while, still in Texas. Texas is gonna be my main thing I'm driving through. Finally, I'm about 50 miles outside of San Antonio, and the landscape has changed again. And leaving San Antonio, I forgot to do a video, I think, yesterday. San Antonio is pretty cool. It's really big, really spaced out. But it's a cool pizza place last night, local, really good beer, hoppy beer. A little bit of a stop. I stopped at an igloo store to check it out, like the actual factory. Really cool. And also stopped at a big gas station called Bucky's. And Bucky's is like this huge gas station, like the biggest gas station you've ever seen in my life. I've ever seen some. Maybe in your life, I don't know if you've seen huge gas stations, but like it had everything you're looking for. Louisiana State Line. Speed limit. Now the speed limit 60. Yeah. Louisiana, had a lot of traffic actually. The weather's not looking too good, but there's a really cool bridge I'm going over. I'm going over some water. It's pretty cool though. It's like about 2 hours and 30 minutes outside of New Orleans. So, let's go.